We will indulge memories as long as they stay where we left them. When we left Tiger Woods, the golfer, he was winning the 2008 U.S. Open on a broken leg and a torn ACL, in sudden death, on the 91st hole, as courageous and foolish a feat as ever in sports. His legend could have stopped there, maybe should have stopped there, and all that has happened since would be forgettable clutter. Woods would still be just a golfer, arguably the greatest golfer, tragically thwarted by fate, his tomorrow's lost and his yesterday's glorious. But, in every interesting life, there is always a but. That a but there is no art. Woods is more than he was on the final green at Torrey Pines. He has stuffed a whole other life into the intervening years, a more arresting life, no pun intended, a life marked by infidelity, idleness and injury. Golf is the least compelling part of it, no part of it at all. Really, he wants to be a golfer again. It is too late for Woods to ever be just a golfer again, and maybe too late to be any kind of golfer again. Woods will return this week to the sanctuary of Mark Twain's Good Walk. Spoiled, in the Bahamas, with just a few friends, as if slipping onto the stage with the chorus. There seems not the same furious curiosity this time, and which time this is maybe lost in the fog of redundancy. Woods and the tide keep coming in and going out. Golf has moved on without Woods, moved on without the same focus and without the same notice, becoming again relatively faceless. It may be possible to pick Jordan Spieth or Rory McIlroy or Ricky Fowler out of a lineup, but you will need an ID plate and a barcode. Which brings us back to Woods. The memory that intrudes now is of Tiger Woods, the other. This is courtesy of a mugshot from the Jupiter, FLA, Police Department. It is the face of a man we do not know, have never been allowed to know, a mere mortal. Caught by poor judgment and harsh lighting. The cost of celebrity always seems too high to those who have it and too generous for those who do not. Fame has been more a friend to Woods than an adversary. When measured out, all that Woods has and all that he is, as well as what he wants to be again, makes a bigger pile than the debris of disgrace. Can Woods be what he was? Of course not. Surgeries and age have taken care of that. Can he be the attention magnet he was? For a while, but that, too, will fade, as it did for Arnold Palmer, for Jack Nicklaus, for every icon of any sport. Michael Jordan can pass relatively freely through life these days. This was true even when he was doing what Woods is trying to do, hang on. No one begrudges any athlete the right to stick around, if only to bridge the gap between wonder and weariness. Between the splendor and the ceremonial. Can Woods settle into the crowd? Can he miss cuts and make them? Can he find the routine enough? Or will he try too hard, as seems to be the root of every physical problem he has had? I was there when Nicklaus played his last round at St. Andrews a dozen years ago. When he knew it was over, he wore the same sweater vest as his last British Open victory, though in a larger size. He was hatless and his golden hair was whiter and thinner. My last day of golf, I wanted to bring a game and a look. Nicklaus tried to explain, wanting what could not be again. Just the wishes of a sentimental old fool. Woods won that Open, obliterating the old course with irons. Present and the past at the same junction. Will Woods ever get a moment like that? Will he ever accept a moment like that? Not yet. He is not ready, nor, at least for the moment, are we. Bernie Lincecum is a special contributor to the Chicago Tribune. Tiger Woods to return November 30th at Hero World Challenge. Tiger Woods pleads guilty to reckless driving, avoids jail. Tiger Woods cleared for golf activities with no restrictions.